Welcome to Java class. Very great day. In today's session, I am going to discussing about applets. The concepts we are going to covering in the applets is inheritance, or how hierarchy was formed based on the inheritance, the differences between the applet and applications, what is the life cycle of an applet, how we are going to passing the parameters to the applets. These are the concepts we are going to covering in this session. The last session we completed the event handling AWS wings. Now we will see the what is an applet. In the last session also I explained what is an applet. It is a specific type of program embedded in the web page to generate the dynamic content, which runs inside the browser. Nothing but when you open the browser, what happens? Specifically, it is embedded in the web page, generates the dynamically content. So there are three advantages. Means works at client side, so less response time and secure it. It can be executed by the browser running under the many platforms. That is the reason applets are very famous. Now let's see the hierarchy of an applet. See, this is an applet containing J applet, applet, and panel, container, component. See here. Applet is a class which extends the panel class, panel which extends a container, container is a subclass of a component. So all these classes are going to be available in applet. Please remember the hierarchy of applet, as we see same thing in components, nothing but every AWT components. Now we are going to discussing the applet concept. Let us see the first what is Java applets and application. First of all, we have to know application. Application is just like the Java program runs under underlying of operating system with the support of a virtual machine. It is known as an application. Nothing but in generally we done some programs. For example, program or nothing but a simple programs we developed in Java run on the machines. So that is called as an application. What comes to the applet? Applet is a Java program that can be embedded into the web pages. Here the important concept is how web page is developed with the help of applets. It runs inside the browser, whatever the browser default browser is there on systems, it's not a matter. The browser is going to be taking the responsibilities and works at client side. An applet is embedded in HTML page using applet code or object tag. See the differences. First is Java application is nothing but a normal program will run on any machines, any operating system by making a virtual machines. There are no GUI, graphical user interfaces, whereas applets that will be run in the browsers, that is called as an applet. Now see the differences between Java applications and applet. Java applications are just like programs. Applets are small Java programs that are designed to included with HTML, hypertext markup language, which is used to display the web content. Requires a main function for execution. Applications nothing but for every program we require main function, but comes to the applets we don't require the main function. You please remember this is very very important. While we are going to developing the applets in Java, we will not write the main function. And programs have full access to local file system and network. So nothing but whatever the program you have written, that can be accessed to files, whatever the files are available and network systems on a local machine is going to be happen. But applets does not have a local disk network access. Application can access all kinds of resource available on the system, because we develop an application that can be interact with all the resources available on the system. But applet can only access the browser specific services. They do not have access to the local system. See here the difference is we can read a file, we can see the image, we can do anything, but whereas here we cannot perform anything or any operations on local machine with the help of applets. Application can execute the program from a local machine. Applets can execute the programs from local machine. Cannot execute the programs on local machine. So these are the differences. The application program is needed to perform some task directly for the users, whereas applet program is needed to perform some small task or the part of it. Next, we are going to see the life cycle and applet. Comes to the life cycle of an applet is nothing but it is having five methods. One is init method, another is start, paint, stop, and destroy. And here five methods are there. Out of five, four methods are belong to the applet class, and the paint method is belongs to the component class. So in general, life cycle of an applet requires five methods. Out of five, the four are belongings to the applet. The five one, the remaining one is going to be belongs to the component. Let's see. The four files are, sorry, the four cycle life cycle methods available in applet java.applet.applet classes. And the remaining one, we will see what are the four and what is the one. The remaining one will be in the AWT abstract window tool.component class. See here, five life cycle methods are there. Four are belongs to the applet of applet class. One is belong to the AWT and component class. Please see what are the four life cycle methods that are available in Java applet. Applet classes: public void init, public void start, stop, and destroy. These four, see here, init, start, stop, and destroy, the four lifecycle methods are available in Java applet.applet classes. Let's see each and every method what it is going to do. This is used to initialize the applet and invoked only once. Okay, invoked only once, and the next is initializing, invoked only once, and start. It is invoked after the init method. Whenever init method is there, after invoke this method is going to be invoked automatically. The browser is going to be maximized. It is used to start the applet. Public void stop is used to stop the applet. It is invoked when the applet is stopped or browser is minimized. And the last one is destroy, which is going to destroy the applet. It also invoked only once. Again, I'm repeating, init is initialization of an applet, invokes only once. Then after successful init, start method is going to be invoked, which where the browser is maximized, which means the start of applet. And the next is stop, means minimizing of a browser, destroying the applet. And one more method is there, paint. Let's see, the paint method is available in java.awt component class. What is the use of this? What is the use of AWT? Abstract window toolkit provides graphic user interfaces. It is used to paint the applet, to provide the graphic class objects that can be used for the drawing oval, rectangle, arc, etc., string, and etc., etc. So what is the use of a paint for the graphic component purpose? That is AWT. That is the reason paint method is stored available in AWT. It provides the graphic class object that can be used for some kind of actions called as drawing, oval, rectangle, and etc. Now, how to run an applet? As we seen in AWT at Sphinx, just creation of a window with the help of panel or a dialog box frame. So now here applet is nothing but program runs a client side in the browser. It's a small piece of a code. So there are two ways to run the applet: by HTML file or by applet viewer. Applet viewer for testing purpose, HTML file for the browsing. Who is the responsible to manage the life cycle of an applet? Here one more question. Java plugin software which is resides in the inside the browser is going to take the responsibility of life cycle applet. Okay, here two ways to run the applet. One is HTML file, another is applet viewer tool. First one, applet. To execute applet by HTML, create an applet and compile it. After creation of applet, create an HTML file and place the applet code in HTML file. Now click the HTML file. Now I will tell you, this is the first step. We are going to writing the applet example. We have to import the package applet of applet, and the next is AWT graphics. Here only we are going to invoking one method, not other four methods. We will see the only first method. This is going to happen or not. Import java.awt.graphics. Now the class name is the first which extends the applet. Applet class is extended, nothing but inheritance. Now what happens here, we can use directly paint method as a graphics. Passing parameter g.drawString. drawString is a static method available in a graphic class. Okay, graphic class. So that is created an object reference as g.drawString. What happened, with the help of a class we are going to calling the drawString method, passing some parameter in the constructor, welcome 150 150. Now this is created. Class must be a public because its object is created by java plugin software that resides on the browser. So here after writing this code, we have not written any main here. Okay, you just save this file as first.java in the same folder, and you write one more code as HTML. Save HTML as myapplet.html. This is saving of a file name is an optional, depends upon the user. So you have to include HTML and close the HTML, open the body, close the body, and applet. In the applet we have to write as it is, applet code is equal to so dot class file. So for this, what dot class file is going to be generated? F first dot class. After compilation of this program, we will generate a dot class file as first dot class. So to what applet should run the code? This code only. This code should be converted into the binary form, nothing but class, first dot class, and you provide some width and height, and close the applet, close the body and HTML. Please remember HTML is a mandatory and body is also mandatory, opening and closing an applet. Whenever you save this file as dot HTML in a particular folder, and that will appear in the default browser form with the name whatever you saved. So here the default browser in my local machine is a Google Chrome. That is the reason the file is appeared like this, myapplet.html. See, this is a program which written in the notepad and saved with the name as first.java. We are going to executing the applet programs. That is the reason we imported applets and graphics extends of applet. Only we are performing one method from AWT to check a sample of a applet drawing of a string. And in the next program, write in HTML, pass the first dot class as a code to applet and save it. This will be appear like this. When you click on this, the browser will be open, and whatever is there, string welcome is going to be displayed on the browser. This type is called applet. Next, applet tool viewer. HTML, the form of HTML that is going to be written in two parts. First part is a coding, the second part is applet code. Okay, applet tool comes to the next concept for testing purpose. Applet tool viewer, applet viewer tool is used to for testing purpose. So first we will see, here we have no need to use the HTML file. What we will do, we will write the program and HTML applet code in the same program. We are not using any HTML. After writing the program, see here, the applet code, whatever the applet code is written in HTML, in the first process of HTML, only this applet code is going to be placed in the same code, and save as a first.java. Okay, and here the condition is execute the applet by applet tool viewer. The command is applet tool viewer first.java. First means the whatever the file name you have given. Here the file name is first. Save the file as first.java. First you compile, and running should be like this. Java C compilation is happened, and running should be done applet viewer first.java. Then output will be displayed like this. Okay, what we written over there, welcome to applet. See, please, welcome to applet we written by paint, using the paint method from invoking of AWT graphics 150 and 150. The same is going to be displayed over here. This is for testing. And if you open the my app applet HTML, the same output is going to be displayed, but this window is in a different form. It will be open in browser format. Now, event handling in applets. As we perform event handling in AWT or Sphinx, we can perform it with applets also. So, by clicking a button or component, object changing of behavior of an object, one form to the another form. Please observe example of event handling in applet. See, I written applet AWT and AWT. Okay, extending of applets implements action listener. Here what we are extending the applets, whereas in previous AWT, here we have to extend the applets, implements the action listener, same as it is event handling in AWT, same that can be implemented in AWT. In the place of AWT, we have to write a applet. So button is in a component, text field is in a component. So why again the button text fields are claimed? So please look at the hierarchy of a applet. Here the applet is extends a panel, container and component. The component may be a button, text box, radio box, checkbox and etc. etc. So that is the reason the component, we used it as component. So here comes to button, text field is initiated, public void init. So same object reference is created, setter boundary, button is created, setter boundary added on the frame, added, B add B, you just add, it, okay. B dot action listener, register for the action listener, this set layout. Now we are not using the frames concept here, this is an applet. Public void action performed, same as it is. Event handling, whatever we done in AWT or Sphinx, same here. but we are extend the applet. The remaining will be the common register for the listener, action performed of a listener, interfaces. Okay, and save it. And you pass the code in HTML file and then execute. What will appears? A button is created. Click, having boundaries, and a text field is boundaries is set. See, it is going to receive tf dot text welcome, some whatever the welcome is there, that is going to be displayed over there. That is is called event handling in applets. Now parameter passing in applet, how we can pass the parameter? It simply comes to the get parameter named public string get parameter, parameter name. Parameter is nothing but a string. That should be a public. Don't get confusion. Get parameter, that should be a string, and access specifier is in a public string parameter name. Now using parameters in applet, you write the same program as it is. See, here I am passing get parameter. We are passing get parameter is a method is assigned to str, which type is string, passing some parameter as msg, and draw that string g dot draw string, draw string str comma 50 and 50. Here str means, what is str? Str is defined as a string variable which is reading some message. Here we did not pass anything. This msg will be passed as a parameter into this method, but what msg should contain, that will be written in the html code. See here, the class name has been given. Here param name, nothing but parameter name is equal to msg. This defines that where parameter name is equal to msg, the value should be welcome to applet. So dynamic, it's not in a static, dynamically we are passing the parameter. See, where the parameter name as a msg, the value should be welcome to applet. Now tell me here, the dot code, after successful compilation of this program, the program name is use param. Compilation, after compilation we will get the class file called as useParam.class. The code is placed over here. In this also we are passing some information like message param name is equal to message, where param name, parameter name is equal to msg, the value should be welcome to applet, and you just save it. This information is going to be passed to the parameter, and that will be displayed on this console. This type is called as parameter passing. With this we completed the fifth unit. In the fifth unit briefly we covered everything, and if anything is there, we will discuss in the next session. Thanks for listening. Thank you.